Section 8 discharge comes in, you'll be the first to know. In the meantime, is that a run in your stocking?
Oh, darn it. Thank you, sir.
Sparks, where's my aftershave? Where's my butter? My butter!
Here, sir. And there, sir.
Good morning, guys. How's your orphanage doing today?
Just fine, lad. The orphanage is doing just fine.
Colonel, Father O'Toole's here to see you.
Oh, good day, Padre. It's always good to see you. How are things at the orphanage?
Just fine, Colonel. Especially with such generosity on your part.
Oh?
Yes, the truckload of food, sea rations, I believe you call them, that you donated so generously.
What sea rations?
The only thing is, Colonel, these cigarettes that came with the food are not really appropriate for the children, so I'm returning them to you.
Sparks, take care of these.
Once again, Colonel, your generosity is overwhelming. Bless you, and good day.
Hey, Padre. Sparks, what was that all about?
Beats me, Colonel. Oh, the motor pool called? Your Jeep is missing.
Gentlemen, it's good to see you again.
Oh, hi, Father.
Long time no see.
Colonel, these men here that you sent to deliver the food this morning are most gracious.
We only send the very best, Padre. Good day, Padre. Hold it right there. Sea rations. My Jeep.
Just a little PR, sir. And may I add how wonderfully refreshed and generous you look this morning, sir.
Yeah, Colonel. A little PR is a good thing, you know. Is that new cologne, sir?
Smells awfully good, sir.
Look, I don't mind helping the Padre out. But this is going too far. You're confined to quarters until I decide what to do with you two.
But, sir, we'll miss the girls.
The quarters, gentlemen, now! Hurry!
Boy, sure is boring around here.
Yeah, I hate to admit it, but I like it when there's a little more excitement going on.
Yeah.
Objection to a general
objection in the morning.
Step aside.
A lot of men did, a lot of men died. One is divine, the other is still in the right.
Come on, catch him.
And the left one will load 60 sons. What a day, another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can.
Go for the gold.
an example of baritone John Forziani. His first career was as a test pilot for the gas company. Now, our tenor, Patrick Casey, he has a background in agriculture and was outstanding in his field. Yeah, that's true. You got me. That's where we found him out, standing in his field. On the other hand, our lead, John Ragunas, John is such a procrastinator. His own mother once told him that he would never amount to anything.
That's all right. I told her, just wait.
On the other hand, I am a successful entrepreneur. My wife and I run an iron and steel business.
Yeah, she irons and he steals.
Well, Ringwood U has a serious side as well. About 2 years ago, a young lady came to us, asked us to sing at her wedding. And since her three older sisters were going to be there, she wanted us to sing a song to all of them. Well, when we looked at the lyrics of our next song, we knew that it was perfect for the occasion. The lyrics take you emotionally from early childhood all the way to the most important day in a young lady's life, and many stops along the way. If you will, think of a young lady in your life as we sing Little Girl. Oh, by the way, that young lady was my youngest daughter.
Little girl.
Now they do. It's on page 3. All right, we're gonna sing the dumb song here.
I wrap the eyes on. these two gentlemen, Murphy and Clancy, walking down the street in the old country that we call Pennsylvania. And as they're walking down the street, they pass a Catholic church. And Murphy says to Clancy, I think I'll go in and have confession. It has been a while. Clancy says, fine, I'll be waiting for you here on the street. So Murphy did go into the church and found an open confessional, and he started. Father, forgive me, for I have sinned. I've had my way with a woman. And from the other side of the screen, I know you for your voice, Murphy, Father says. Can you tell me who the woman was? And Murphy said, it's not a proper question, Father, and I'll not be answering it. He said, was it with the widow O'Grady? Murphy didn't answer. Was it with O'Shaughnessy's sister? And again, Murphy did not answer. Was it with O'Reilly's daughter? And Murphy said, that's the third time you'd be asking me, Father. And for the third time, I'll not be telling you. Well, then you get no absolution from me, Murphy, Father said. Get out of my church. So Murphy left the confessional. And he left the church. He made it to the street, and Clancy said, well, did you get absolution? Murphy said, no, but I got three good leads.
Mammy mine, you're a rolling stone.
bees known to man, and some known only to horses, judging by the size of those needles. But what a flight we had coming in. The gunners were all at their turrets, and the guy from New York Light was sitting next to me, tearing up my life insurance policy and eating all the pieces. Well, I tried to stop him, and he bit me. It didn't bleed very much. But the young GI who was managing me looked a little nervous, so I said to him, how did you become a medic? He said, drafted. I said, well, I mean, were you an intern? He said, no. Well, were you a med student? He said, no. Well, I said, how did you become a medic then? He said, well, the draft board was interviewing me, and they gave me an application to fill out, and the part that said, what was your last job? I filled in Dr. Pepper. And Miss America was a little nervous, too. Poor girl, she kept insisting that I sit on her lap and suck my thumb and call her mommy. But boy, it was hot when we arrived. I think this is the first time I ever laid fried eggs. But you know, they put us up in a fine hotel. The shell holes in the walls to add to the ventilation. And there's a sign that says, keep your doors locked at all times. It helps to hold the walls up. But boy, do I have a guest for you guys right now. She's the reigning Miss America. Down, boys, down, down. She came in the same flight with me, and I kept asking her to help me adjust my oxygen mask. And then she reminded me that we hadn't taken off yet. But here she is, Miss America. Yes, sir.
Let's take a plane to St. Paul. Let's take a kayak to Quincy or Niagara.
jokes were going to start popping. But seriously, all you guys are heroes to me. And speaking of heroes, here's one of your own buddies who's a hero in his own hometown, right here.
Like his daddy on the 17th of March, did you notice all the lovely ladies?
greatest quartet. You know, one that has the very best voices that money can buy. Well, the boys are gonna help me show you just what I mean.
If I had my way, boys, this quartet would be Carreras, Domingo, Pavarotti, and me. A four-star performance there on TV.
Very, very nice prize. And so if you haven't taken a
stance on that basket of cheer out there. You might want to do it while you're out in the lobby. We'll be back in here in 15 minutes. We've got a lot of great people. See you then.
Songs that make you want to dance. No one's moving. about each one of us and where we come from and so forth. And actually, then we'd like to get to know all of you as well. So we're going to start over here. Just
Actually, our tenor singer, Terry, he used to work.
been used in my life, since we all kind of told a little bit about everything, Gary with his new baby and everything, and Kevin being one of the voices of Disney, little more than a year ago, I got married. It's a very cool thing. And we celebrated our anniversary. Oh. About two weeks ago, we celebrated our one-year anniversary, and actually, my wife's name is Jody also, but it's not the same to be a thing. Different people altogether. And 2 weeks ago, we had the distinct pleasure, and privilege, 3 weeks ago, actually, of being in Paris, France. The quartet had a gig, a performance there overseas, two performances, and my honey, Jody, wanted to come along with me, and which, you know, I thought was kind of cool, going to France and everything, and we celebrated our one-year anniversary now, which was really pretty cool. Of course, I've set myself up for a big fall, because, you know, I don't know how you top Paris, you know, for my second anniversary. I'm ready to go.
Disney World.
Sparkles and sparkles and shines. Come with me and
So when they take a drive out to country or something. And your roads, they go straight for a while and then they always have a little
thank you.
kinds of people in the world today? Those who can count and those who can't.
Thank you.
careful look at the kinds of people who are writing these songs. It's amazing how these names keep coming up all the time, and yet you're not really aware that these are famous composers that are doing these songs for us. Well, such a composer wrote the next song that we'll be singing for you, and his name is Milton Deluc. Now, does that ring any bells for anybody out there? Milton Deluc was the director of the NBC Johnny Carson Show Orchestra before Bach Seppelt. Milton Deluc and the NBC Orchestra. Still doesn't ring any bells. Well, let me tell you that he wrote a great song. This is Orange Colored Sky.
Yeah.
wine barons to you and beyond this auditorium throughout the world. We just hope for peace on earth. Please, let there be peace. Well, and also